Good afternoon students, welcome back to online mathematics class. In the last class we have started with the exercise 7.9 and we have solved up to the 7th question. So in today's class let us continue with the next one. It is the 8th one. The given integral is integral pi by 6 to pi by 4 cosecant x dx. So let us take this as I which is equals to integral pi by 6 to pi by 4 cosecant x dx. So this is the standard formula, integration of cosecant x dx. I which is equals to log mod cosecant x minus cot x. Then apply the limit now. Pi by 6 to pi by 4. Pi by 6 to pi by 4. So now upper limit minus the lower limit. Which is equals to log mod cosecant x. X is nothing but pi by 4 now. Pi by 4 minus cot pi by 4. So this is the upper limit minus the lower limit minus log mod cosec pi by 6 minus cot pi by 6. So let us substitute the values of cosecant pi by 4, cot pi by 4 and cosecant pi by 6 and cot pi by 6. I which is equals to log mod cosecant pi by 4 is nothing but 1 by sin pi by 4. Take up the reciprocal. It becomes root 2 minus cot pi by 4 value, it is 1. Then minus log mod complete. So cosecant pi by 6 is going to be 1 by sin pi by 6. Sin pi by 6 value, it is 1 by 2. So this has to be 2 minus. Now cot pi by 6 or 1 by tan pi by 6. Tan pi by 6 or tan 30 degree value, it is 1 by root 3. So take up the reciprocal, it becomes root 3. So now this is in the form of log x minus log y. It is log x by y. I which is equals to log mod, then here we write root 2 minus 1, root 2 minus 1 divided by 2 minus root 3. Since it is a definite integral, we should not write plus c. So this is the answer for the 8th problem. Well, the 9th question, it is integral 0 to 1 dx by under root 1 minus x square. So take this as I which is equals to integral 0 to 1 dx upon square root of 1 minus x square. So this is the standard formula, integration of dx by under root 1 minus x square is nothing but sine inverse x. So here I which is equals to sine inverse x, then 0 to 1. So let us apply the limit now. I which is equals to, so it is sine inverse 1 upper limit, sine inverse 1 minus sine inverse 0. So what is sine inverse 1? It is pi by 2. Then minus sine inverse 0, it is 0. So pi by 2 minus 0, it is pi by 2. I which is equals to pi by 2. So then we'll move on to the next question now. So let us solve the 10th one. the 10th question it is integral 0 to 1 dx upon 1 plus x square. 0 to 1 dx upon 1 plus x square. So let us take this as I. Take this as I, then 0 to 1 integral 0 to 1 dx upon 1 plus x square. Then I which is equals to tan inverse x integration of dx by 1 plus x square is nothing but tan inverse x. So apply the limit now. 0 to 1. So now I which is equals to tan inverse 1 minus tan inverse 0. So tan inverse 1 value it is pi by 4. So this has to be pi by 4 minus 0. So I which is equals to pi by 4 minus 0 it is pi by 4. So this is the answer for the 10th problem. Well, the next question it is integral 2 to 3 dx by x square minus 1. So let us take this as I which is equals to integral 2 to 3 dx upon x square minus 1. Dx upon x square minus 1. So now this is there in the standard form of integration dx by x square minus a square. So what is the formula of integration of dx by x square minus a square? It is 1 by 2a log mod x minus a divided by x plus a. So say here I which is equals to 1 divided by 2 into a. In place of a we have 1. So 2 into 1. So this 1 can be written as 1 square. So that we get the standard form. Then log mod x minus a, that is x minus 1, divided by x plus 1. Then mod complete. Then the limit 2 to 3. Let us apply the limit here. 2 to 3. Then I which is equals to 1 by 2 into 1 it is 2. So I write 1 by 2 log mod x minus 1 divided by x plus 1, then mod complete. So the limit is 2 to 3. Now we have to go for upper limit minus the lower limit. I which is equals to 1 by 2 log. Go for the upper limit now. In place of x, we have to write 3. So 3 minus 1 divided by 3 plus 1. So this is upper limit minus the lower limit. Minus 1 by 2 log mod. See here, in place of x, I have to write 2. 2 minus 1 divided by 2 plus 1. Let us simplify this now in the next step. I which is equals to, see here, 1 by 2 log, what happens now? 3 minus 1, it is 2. Then here we get 4. So 2 by 4, it is 1 by 2. So this has to be 1 by 2. Then minus 1 by 2, log, what do we get now? 2 minus 1 it is 1. 1 divided by 3. So we get 1 by 3. So in this we can take 1 by 2 common. So let us take 1 by 2 common here. 1 by 2 common. Then it will be in the form of log x minus log y. So it is log of x by y. 1 by 2 whole divided by 1 by 3. So now see here, if you take up the reciprocal, this becomes 1 by 2. Then So it can be written as log 3 by 2. So this is the answer for the 11th problem. Well, the 12th question, it is integral 0 to pi by 2 cos square x dx. So I'll be taking this as I which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2 cos square x dx. So I which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2, then cos square x can be written as 1 plus cos 2x by 2. So it has to be 1 plus cos 2x divided by 2 dx. So here 1 by 2 is a constant. I'll be writing it outside. So which is equals to 1 by 2. Then here we have 0 to pi by 2. 1 plus cos 2x. 1 plus cos 2x dx. Now integrate them separately. I which is equals to, so write 1 by 2 outside as it is, then integration of 1, it is x, plus integration of cos 2x will be sin 2x by 2. Sin 2x divided by 2, then apply the limit now, 0 to pi by 2. Now we have to go for upper limit minus the lower limit. I which is equals to, so 1 by 2 will be related to both the terms, that is why I am going to consider flower bracket. Then here upper limit, in place of x you write pi by 2 plus, so here we have to write pi by 2. So see here, sine 2 into pi by 2 whole divided by 2, this is the upper limit minus the lower limit. Minus lower limit will be 0. See here, in place of x you have to write 0. This term is 0. Then sine 2 into 0. So sine 0 is 0. 0 by 2 is again 0. So 0 plus 0, I have written 0 directly. Then let us simplify this. I which is equals to 1 by 2. Then here pi by 2. Plus 2 and 2 get cancels. We have sine pi. Sine pi value, it is 0. 0 by 2, it is 0. Then I which is equals to 1 by 2 into pi by 2. 1 by 2 into pi by 2. So will give us pi by 4. So this is the answer for the 12th question. Pi by 4. Well, the 13th problem, it is integral 2 to 3 x dx divided by x square plus 1. So I'll be taking this as I which is equals to integral 2 to 3 x dx divided by x square plus 1. So now here multiply and divide by 2, so that we get into the form of integration of f dash f x by f of x dx. So I which is equals to 1 by 2, then integral 2x dx divided by x square plus 1. So now see here, if you cancel out these two, we get back the previous term. So this is in the form of integral f dash of x by f of x. It is log mod f of x. I which is equals to 1 by 2 log mod f of x. That is x square plus 1. Then apply the limit. So sorry, it has to be 2 to 3. So let us apply the limit 2 to 3. So here I which is equals to 1 by 2, then so upper limit In place of x, we have to write 3. We get log mod 3 square. It will be 9. 9 plus 1, it is 10. 10. Then minus the lower limit, log mod 2 square. 2 square will be 4. 4 plus 1, it is 5. So now in the next step, I which is equals to 1 by 2. Now this is there in the form of log x minus log y. It is log x by y. So this has to be log 10 by 5. Log 10 by 5. What is 10 by 5? So 5 ones are 5 twos are. I which is equals to 1 by 2 log 1 by 2 log 2, or else this can also be written as, it is in the form of n log x. N log x means log x raised to n, 2 raised to 1 by 2. I which is equals to log 2 raised to 1 by 2. I which is equals to log root 2. So anyway, we can stop the problem at here itself also. So this is all about the 13th problem.